everyone, this is eduNIC. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to convert from one number system to another. So as you may know, there are four different number systems: decimal number system, the binary, the octal, and the hexadecimal number system. So each one is different, that is, each one has a base different, that is, decimal has base 10 and uses digits 0 to 9 to represent the numbers, while binary has base 2, therefore only two values, that is 0 and 1. On the other hand, octal has base 8 and uses 0 to 7, that is 8 numbers, and hexadecimal has base 16, therefore 16 characters, which is 0 to 9, and then from A to F, that is, there is 0 to 9, and then we have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, which represented by the letters A, B, C, D, E, and F. So if we have letter B, say, we are going to take the value 11 to calculate the conversion. First of all, let's look at the decimal and binary interconversions. From this, you can understand all those other conversions. So let's move right into it. So to understand the conversion, I'm considering a problem or example like this. Let me consider a binary number, which is to be converted into our decimal number system. That is, this is our number. And we have to convert this into its decimal equivalent. So what we do is, we just name the places, that is, this is 0th place, which and this is 1's place, and similarly, I number each one. So what we have to do is, we have to multiply the digit with the with a 2 raised to the position it is in. That is, this will be equal to, I'm starting from this point and going to this, and 0 into 2 raised to 0 plus 1 into 2 raised to 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to 2 and 0 into 2 raised to 3 plus 0 into 2 raised to 4 plus 1 into 2 raised to 5 plus 1 into 2 raised to 6 plus 1 into 2 raised to 7. So this will be equal to our decimal number. When calculating the powers, we get 2 plus 4 plus 32 plus 64 plus 128, which adds up to 230. Therefore, 1110011 will be equal to 230 in its decimal form. Now, suppose we have a point 0.01 at the end, so we just have to multiply it with the corresponding powers, that is 2 raised to minus 1 and 2 raised to minus 2. Here we must add 0 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 2. 2 raised to minus 2 is 1 by 4, which gives 0.25, which therefore our new answer would be 230.25. Let's convert a decimal number into binary. Decimal to binary. Let's just take the same number, that is 230.25, to convert. Now, first we take this portion, that is the number before the decimal point, and sort of factorize it or divide it continuously by 2, because we are converting it into binary. That is 2, when we divide by 2, 230, we get 115 with the remainder 0. Write down the reminders by the side, because this is important. And again, when we divide by 2, we get 57 with a remainder 1. We do not require decimal numbers here, we require whole numbers. So on continuing, we get 28 with a remainder 1, and 14 with a remainder 0, 7 with a remainder 0, 6, 7 remainder 1, and 2 with a remainder 1, and the last division with 0 times 2 and with a remainder 1. And this is very important. Now we have to write down these numbers or these reminders from bottom to the top, which would give us the equivalent of 230, which is 111 00 110. This 0 is it is not required. If you want, you can also write it down, because it makes no difference. Now this is the equivalent of 230 in binary form. Now we have to find out that of 0.25. 0.25 or the decimal part, we have to multiply continuously by 2. On multiplying, we get 0.5. And first we take this 0 and write it down after the point here. Now we take this portion, that is here, it is only 0.5, and multiply it again by 2, which would give us a 1.0. And we write down this part that is left of that point and write it down here. And again we multiply this part by 2, which again gives us 0. So if we continue division, we get a 0. So we stop at this point. If we are not getting a 1, a perfect 1, you can stop the multiplication at some 3 or 4 points. So this is our basic conversion from decimal to binary and binary to decimal. So to just brief the whole procedure, if we have to convert from binary to a decimal, we just multiplied each number by 2 raised to the corresponding position. That is, and when we are converting it back, that is decimal to binary, we divided by 2 for the part on left of the decimal point, and for that part after the decimal point, we continue multiplication by 2. The other two number system, that is octal and hexadecimal, the process is actually the same. We just have to replace these twos by the corresponding base of the number, that is 8 for octal, and hexa we get 16. I have just written down the procedures, which is exactly the same as we have done with the binary to decimal interconversions. Now let's just consider a single example for each of them. So let's just consider a question. We have to convert 100 decimal into octal. So what would we do? That is, decimal to octal, we have to divide continuously by 8. So we have 100 by 8. 12 times is 96. Therefore, 100 minus 96 is 4 is the remainder. And again, we divide one time, we get 4 remainder. And again, we divide, so we get 0 and 1. Now we consider it from bottom to top. Therefore, 100 decimal is equal to 144 in octal. So next, suppose we have a hexadecimal number A10B, and this needs to be converted to decimal. We just mark the positions of these numbers 1, 2, and 3, and now we just have to identify the values of these letters. That is, we have 0 to 9, and then for A there is 10, and therefore this is 10, and next value B is 11. So now For hexadecimal, we have to multiply by the powers of 16. Therefore, from here, that is 11 into 16 raised to 0 plus 0 into 16 raised to 1 plus 1 into 16 raised to 2 plus 10 into 16 raised to 3. So writing down the values, I got something like this, and on adding, value was turned out to be 41,227 in decimal. So this is how you convert between the various number systems, and so practice with more problems, and this will be very easy. So like this video, subscribe my channel. Thank you.